Bonjour, mesdames et messieurs. In this video, I want to show you how you can use a radial filter in Lightroom and how I use it. Let me know how you use it in the comments, but let's get started. So for example, this beautiful photo of Iceland that I took 2 years ago, I want to just make the sunset pop a little bit more. I want to make the ice cube pop a little more. So I'm going to go here to my radial filter. If you double click on effect, everything comes down to zero. And what I want to do, so I'm going to show you how the radial filter works. So let's say I'm going to add a bit of exposure and I click and drag, I make a circle, okay? Now there's a very important option here, which is called invert. By default, yours might be this way. The way it works is that this exposure that I added here is being added everywhere, but not in a circle. If I click on invert, now it's in the circle, okay? Now, another very option that's very important, is the feathering. If the feathering is done at zero, check it out, what's gonna happen? It's not gonna look very natural. You're gonna really see the circle. But if you put all the way to 100, it's gonna be a more subtle, okay? Also, another option that's very important is you can click here on Show Mask Overlay, and you can see in red what the mask, what the circle is influencing. You also have a few options which are interesting here, which is the Show Edit Pin. By default, it's on auto, okay? Auto means that you have a circle, and if you move your mouse away, up, the circle disappears, so you can appreciate the photo with the circle to see what it does. Check it out, before, after. You know, on that little panel, you got this little square, before and after. Now, you have another option here called Always. And always means it's always gonna be on. Even if I go somewhere else, it's always gonna be on, which is annoying. I never use that option. And then you have selected. Now selected works if you have different circle. The only one that's visible is the one that's selected. You cannot select the old one, which is kind of annoying. So I never use that option. And then you have never. Never is you just don't see the circles at all. Sometimes I use it to sort of appreciate the photo, the before and after, but I find the best of both worlds is auto. Because with auto, you just go out and you can appreciate the photo without the circle. Okay, let me erase this one. This is the circle. What I'm gonna do with this one, I just wanna make that ice cube pop a little more. So my rule of thumb when I add exposure is never, never to go above one. I actually like to be under 0.5. In this case, I might, because it's a big circle, I might go to one, or I give you a trick, which is kinda cool. You can go to 0.5, and you make the circle smaller. Smaller the circle, the more visible it's going to be in a way, which is kind of weird. And you right click and you duplicate and you make another circle here. So now you got two circles and they are both at 0.54. And it just, you see, it complexifies the light. The light is more complex. What that means is that before, let me go to never to show you what I mean. Before the circle, you see the light is kind of dark, it becomes bright and becomes dark again, becomes bright again. So we're just making the light more complex. And photography is all about the light. You want to do it just a little bit, you know, sort of to respect the tradition of dodge and burn that has existed through the years. So, you know, I try to not do it too much. Let's go back on auto. And, or you can make one big circle at one if you want. But I think it's more powerful to make smaller circle and just put some emphasis. And I just right click and I duplicate. And I put it in some different locations on the photo. Right click and duplicate. And then if you want to see before and after, you just go down here and you go before, after. Pretty cool. Now, one other use that I do is usually to make the sunset pop. So I make a big circle here. And in this case, I'm not gonna add exposure, I'm just gonna add a bit of magenta and a bit of yellow. And you see how that makes, look, check it out. Before, after. It's kind of subtle, you don't wanna overdo it, but it just makes the photo pop a little bit. I mean, you can go so extreme. For example, on this photo, I have a whole tutorial on how I did this photo, and I turned it into like a night photo using the circle. You must get the video somewhere else. Now, I also use a circle for black and white. This is a good black and white, but I want to make it pop. So I abuse it on black and white. So I'm going to make a circle. I'm going to click and drag. I just want to make that ice cube more. So on black and white, I usually not go 1.62. That's too much. But I do go a little more over, like around 1-ish. In color, 0.5. And then I'm going to duplicate it, and I'm going to duplicate here and duplicate it here. I always like to lighten a little bit my skies here. And then I'm going to right click and duplicate, and I want to put one here on the water. And you see, it's called like a clair obscur, meaning you're going from darkness to brightness. You're relighting your photo, but you're doing it locally. And I love that about the circle. Maybe this one's a little strong. And you can, you know, since you're using, you can click on the pin and you can adjust it as you want. And also what you can do is, which is pretty cool, let's say I like what it does on the sky, but I don't like what it does here. You got two options. You can go here into the range mask. You can go to luminance and hold down the option key. And it's going to create a mask. You see, by default, the radial circle is white. And what I'm doing is affecting all the white. But if I move this to the right, what it does, it creates a mask. And now it's going to affect a little less the other ice cube and only the sky. So now it affects everything, only the sky. Affects everything, only the sky. And you can even fine-tune that even more by going to this brush, not that brush, this brush. And you can, I advise you to click the show selected mask overlay so you can see what the circle is doing. And I can go here to brush, I can go here to delete, to erase, make sure that auto mask is off and flow is like in a 70. Flow is the power of the eraser. I don't want it to be too powerful. And you see, now I got a brush that's got a minus, and I can say, okay, I like what the circle is doing on the sky, but I don't want it to affect the ice cube at all. Okay? And then you're like, yeah, but I don't want it to affect this ice cube here. So what you can do, because it's kind of like, if I go here, it's going to erase it. You can see it erases everywhere. It erases it also on the sky. So, sorry, I'm going to press Command Z to undo that last stroke. And that's when I'm going to use Auto Mask. And the way Auto Mask works is make sure your eraser minus is on the item. And check this out. So one click, and basically because I've got Auto Mask on, what it does, it only erases the effect of the circle just on the ice cube and not on the sky. So now I can take this out, and you see I'm making the sky brighter, but not the iceberg, only the sky. So it's a very powerful tool because local adjustment is everything, but please, please don't overdo it. By the way, guys, I got a new toolbox that just came out, which is really cool. It's got new brushes, new textures. It's got some of my best preset. It's completely free. You can get it done there. Once you get it, and you make sure you put the right email, otherwise it's not gonna work. You put the right email. As soon as you put your email, you will also get the opportunity to maybe get all my presets at a crazy price. Basically what's gonna happen, once you put in your email, it's gonna send an email with the instruction to give you the toolbox. And in the meantime, I'm gonna propose you to get all my presets. Why not? Also, if you can like this video, it really helps other people to find out about it. Let me know in the comments also what you want to learn, and subscribe to this channel if you didn't subscribe, because I try to make 1 to 2 videos per week. So voila, let me show you this black and white without the circle again, before and after. So before the, without the circle, after the circle, without the circle, after the circle. The radial circle is an incredible tool. Use it with your photo. Download my free toolbox, because also I forgot to tell you, but I give you a whole bunch of beautiful raw files from all over the world, which you can practice the radial filter onto. So link under the video, go crazy. I'll see you in another video. Au revoir.